Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. It's been the weekend, sorry. I want to just do another upgrading my wishlist, yes or not so much, because I've missed like 2 weeks in a row now and I really enjoy making these videos. So I thought, yeah, it's Monday. I don't care, I'm just going to film it. And I have a lot of stuff this time I'm really interested in. So please keep on watching and see what I am going to get, or at least going to put on the wish list. As per usual, I'm going to be a lot on my phone. I'm going to be on the Trendmood and the Beauty News page to see what else is, yeah, what kind of makeup releases are coming our way or already released. So yeah, but let's just dig into the new makeup. Okay, as you see, I scooched over. I'm going to be on my phone, as I said, on the Trendmood and the Beauty News page. And I'm going to start off with Dermalogica. Dermalogica is coming out with a new serum. It's coming soon and it's going to be a firming serum. And they say it's going to be their most advanced dual face serum. And it combines highly active botanicals with biomimetic technology to reduce visible signs of skin aging and reactivate the nature of younger looking skin. It's coming soon, August 30th, so that's quite soon. It's like 1.5 weeks. Nothing about the price, but I think this is quite an intriguing product, especially because I want to use something like a firming serum on my neck and on my chest area. So I might pick this up. I'm going to put it on the wish list. I might pick this up just to use it for that. I don't know what the price is going to be. So if it's going to be extremely expensive, I don't know what I'll do, but it's Dermalogica, so I am expecting not a very cheap price tag. But I want to put it on the wishlist because I'm quite intrigued by it. So yeah, that is what I'm going to do. Then I'm going to CoverFX have released a new powder. And it's a new setting powder, and they have a light and a deep one. The light is a shimmering champagne and the deep one is a shimmering bronze. They are available now at Sephora and Ulta Beauty and at CoverFX website. And it will be $35. Yeah, what are they saying about this? I am intrigued. They say that this weightless loose powder extends makeup wear without settling into fine lines and acts as a luminous filter for the face. The skin-loving formula is enriched with green tea leaves and vitamin C, E, and F to soothe skin and help protect against free radicals. It's recommended for all skin types. I don't know, I don't really believe that a powder could be like suitable for oily and dry. It's one or the other, I think. But yeah, it's something you will... yeah, it's something you will have to see for yourself. I think I'm not going to put it on the wish list. I'm not intrigued enough by this to put it on the wish list. I think there are other powders that I want to try first before this. So yeah, it's just so you know, it's here. Next up is the Jackie Aina and Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. I've heard some mixed messages or mixed comments on this, because a lot of people are like, oh, it looks so the same, and it's so the same as all the other palettes from Anastasia Beverly Hills. If you put them all together, you can see that it's all dupes for each other, and I understand that. I can see that for a little bit, but I have to say that I think that the colors in this are way deeper, way richer, and I think ultimately more suitable for deeper skin tones, because a lot of the complaints I hear or I see when I watch YouTubers with a slightly deeper skin tone or way deeper skin tone than I have, they have to dip in, pat on to get a little bit of the color that is and the pan. So I can understand that you would, if you have a deeper skin tone, that you want some more bold colors that are really going to show up on your skin. And I must say that I really like the color she picked out. It's really Jackie Aina. She uses a lot of purples. The golds are very nice. I think the champagne colors in the shimmers are really nice. I love that color. It's called Sponsored, I think. It's like a duochrome green to brown type of color. Yeah, I really enjoy these colors, and I think it is going on the wish list, guys. I love ABH, you can see right here, I've got a lot of the palettes. I've not all of them, I don't have Prism, but it's, I think it's fun to collect them. I always enjoy their formula, I always enjoy the colors. So I think I'm going to pick this up if I will be able to do that. It's going to be $45 US. And then next up is Too Faced. Too Faced is expanding their Tutti Frutti collection with an injection of watermelon, and they are going to release an eye palette that is going to be $42 US. They're going to release a candy finish lip, $20 US in three shades. They're going to have the Hangover 3-in-1 replenishing primer and setting spray in watermelon for $32 US, and a special edition Better Than Sex mascara for $25. Well, they always do that with the Better Than Sex mascara. Well, yeah, I think this looks really cute, especially because it's watermelon. I really like watermelon themed stuff, especially when it smells like watermelon. Also, I think I've already spoke about the watermelon primer and setting spray, and I think they're both on the wish list already. I like the swatches from the palette, eyeshadow palette, but it's, I have a lot of these colors, so I'm not going to put any of this other than the Hangover primer and the setting spray that I already have on the wish list. Other than that, I'm not going to add anything from this because I think it's cute and all, but I think that if I get a new eyeshadow palette now, I really want it to be unique and something I'm really curious to try. And I've already tried Too Faced eyeshadow palettes. They don't wow me necessarily. I like them, but they don't wow me. And this color scheme, I think it's fun and I think it fits, but it's not something I'm like, yes, I want to have it. So I'm not going to put it on the wish list. Next up is e.l.f. e.l.f. is releasing a new eyeshadow palette. It's called Earth and Ocean. So you have on one side, you've got the blues for the ocean. On the other side, you have the greens for Earth. And yeah, it's going to be $14 US. I think it's a very cute color scheme because you have the type of greens and browns that are really trending right now. So I think this is a very smart palette of theirs. I have no idea how the quality is of e.l.f. Cosmetics eyeshadow palettes because I don't have any eyeshadow palettes from e.l.f. I've never tried any eyeshadow palettes from e.l.f. I believe the Opposites Attract, is it the Opposites Attract or is it NYX? I don't know for sure, but the Opposites Attract one got a lot of great reviews. So I think it's a good thing just to wait until like Emily Noel, for example, or Ellie Kleins tried this palette to see what they think, because there are some fun little colors in here. I don't need it. I think I don't want to say I can dupe the whole thing, but it's not, for me, not interesting enough to get it. But I think it's a nice release by e.l.f. Next up is the Kevin Kwan Foundation Balm that has launched already. I've seen Mel Thompson and Charlotte Holdcroft already reviewing this foundation. They really liked it. And I'm intrigued. I'm intrigued, guys, because it's, for me, it's quite a new type of formula. I've never tried a balm foundation before, and I've never tried anything by Kevin Kwan. And I think I've one or two of his books, so I'm really curious to see how this is going to perform. It looked really, really pretty on Mel and really pretty on Charlotte, and they were both raving about it. So I'm going to put this on the wish list. It is, I think, $52 US. Yes, it's $52 US, and it comes with an additional brush. So you get the brush and the foundation. And I am going to put it on the wish list. With a little bit of a side note, that I want to be able to swatch it in store, because I understand that the shade range, it's not great. That's one, but two, it's quite difficult to see what your shade is. So I don't really want to order this online, and I'm going to see if I can find it in store when I am in London. I'm not sure if I will be able to do that, but I'm just going to try and see. So that would be a cool thing, but it's going on the wish list. I think it's interesting enough to, yeah, to put it on there. The next thing is also going on the wish list. Dang, this video is going to make me bankrupt, seriously. It's the Smashbox Cover Shot Eye Palettes. They are releasing two. And I've never tried anything by Smashbox. I have watched a few will I buy it type of videos from other YouTubers about this these palettes, and they get a little bit of a mixed review because the colors are really nice and the colors are really jumping out at people, and they're like, oh, that's intriguing, yeah, I like the color scheme. But a lot of people say that the formula of Smashbox Covershot eyeshadow palettes aren't the best. But I've never tried them, so I'm going to be a bit of a maverick and I'm going to just try them for myself. I am not totally concluded which one I want to get. I don't know for sure because I really like them both. And I don't think I should get them both, so I'm leaning more to the desert one. That's the one with the green. But I really love the blue and the teal one as well. And that's the denim one. So yeah, they're going to be $29 each. So I think that's going to be the same price, around that same price in Holland. So, and I don't think that's a very bad price. So I might, you know, I think I'll just put desert on my wish list. And then if I like the formula and if I like what it's doing and if I like how it's performing, then I will get the denim as well. Because I don't think they're going to be limited edition. Doesn't say, so I don't think so. So yeah, on the wish list. Okay, this is bad. Next thing is by Maybelline. Maybelline is launching, or yeah, they have launched already a new collection of City Heat lipsticks. They are NYC inspired and they're warm nude shades, and you can see that they are very indeed warm reddish brownish type of colors. They there are six colors, and they are called Brooklyn Bear, East Village Rose, Medicine Red, Midtown Pink, NoHo Amber, and SoHo Nudes. So yeah, I think they look really really cute, and Maybelline has a very, I think, a very nice lipstick formula. So if this comes to Holland, I will probably swatch it in store. But I'm not, it's not like it's the most intriguing launch out of all the stuff I'm talking about this week. So I'm not going to put it on the wish list because I don't think it needs a spot there. But yeah, I really enjoy, I really enjoy the lipstick formula by Maybelline. So I don't think you can go wrong there. But also the reds are quite nice. So yeah, you can try this if you want. Okay, then the next thing is by Sugar Pill. Everybody is going nuts over this little palette. I think it's cute, and I think the colors are really cute as well. And I've heard that Sugar Pill has a very good formula as it comes to these type of colorful mattes. The packaging is adorable, really adorable, with a pixeled cat on it. And I think it is going to launch. It's already launched. It was available at last Tuesday, the 13th of August, and it is going to be $28. It's vegan and cruelty free, and I am not going to put it on the wish list because I never wear these type of colors. A few of them I already kind of have, so it's like, okay, it's not for me, it's not revolutionary enough. And what I want to do, I want to dip my toes into colorful shadows a little bit more, but I want to start with Lethal Cosmetics. I have a very big order like waiting for me to click for checkout. At the moment, I made two palettes on their website, and I think there are some colors that are quite the same or just in the same spectrum. So I don't think, yeah, this is just not really intriguing me enough to put it on the wish list. But it's a very fun, cute little palette, and I think that the colors are really, really cute. Next up is Trend Mood is working with Milani, and what they are going to do, they are putting displays in stores where you can get Milani. And what they are wanting to do, what Trend Mood wants to do, is kind of showing off the Milani products that you normally can't find in stores. So you can swatch them, you can't touch them. And she's like, okay, that needs to be in store more. So they are going to put displays on a lot of their stuff, because a lot of their retailers can't display everything they have. So this is something, and I think it's very call from Trendmoog to say, okay, this is something I want to do. She is a news, a makeup news Instagram page. She's not a influencer in the type that she's doing makeup on her channel or on Instagram or anything like that. But she is really about bringing the news of makeup and the stuff of makeup, all the information about new makeup to her public. So I think it's a very cool thing for her to be collaborating the way that she is doing with Milani right now. I wish we would have Milani available in stores here in Holland. We don't. I have to get it from a website. So I really feel how annoying it can be that you can't see and swatch everything in store. So I think this is just so smart. And I think it could be the future of shopping. Just having a display with everything there so you can swatch it. You can't buy it, but you can swatch it so you know what to get, and then you go online and you order. I think that is maybe the future of shopping. So yeah, nothing to do with a wish list. I just wanted to let you know because I think it's really cool. Then Urban Decay. Urban Decay, this is also something that has some mixed reviews. Urban Decay is going to release a new Naked palette. It's going to be the Naked Honey. And a lot of people are like, honey, it's not even yellow. There's nothing very special about this palette. It's just a neutral palette. And I'm like, when I first saw this, when I first saw the colors, I was like, wow, these browns, the undertone of these browns, that like goldeny, yellowy undertone that they're working with, because it's not really warm, it's not really cool, but it's somewhere in between. It's like a very neutral color scheme. And yeah, it's maybe it's not extremely revolutionary, but on the other hand, I'm like, it's very on trend. And a lot of people are like, no, it's not, it's neutral, it's boring, you should have yellows. And I'm like, have you ever had any honey? Honey is like a golden color, or if you have the we call it Lindenbloesem in Holland, that it's very white looking. It's never pure yellow. I think if you have a pure yellow honey, I don't think you should eat it. So I think that these colors are really on theme, and I think they're very trendy because it's like this, what I said, this goldeny, mossy type of undertone that is really hot right now. Everybody's looking for that. And I think that the third shade from the left and the fifth shade from the left and the fourth from the right are really intriguing. I don't know if I have colors in my collection that are that undertone. Yeah, maybe in my Gemini palette, but that's very, very, a very special palette, a very standalone palette in that regard. So if you see the marketing picture just from the palette above the they're not swatches, but they're like the loose pigments, like photo thing. Okay, the palette doesn't look too good, but if you just look at if the colors are going to be the same as these loose shadows that you see on the bottom of the picture, then I am really intrigued. So I'm going to put it on the wish list because I want to see it live. I want to see it in store. I want to be able to swatch it. I want to be able to see if it's going to be any good, yes or no. It's going to launch mid-September. There's nothing about pricing, about anything like that. But for me, this is intriguing. To me, this is on trend. And I think you can create some really beautiful looks with it. Yes, it's neutral, but a lot of us gals just work at the office or work somewhere where we can, you know, wear extremely bold makeup. So this is, you know, going to be great for an everyday thing, but a little bit more special than just your usual brown eyeshadow palette. So I'm seriously not hating it. I'm seriously liking it. So yeah, Urban Decay Honey Palette. Next up, ColourPop. ColourPop has done this rainbow collection type of thing, and I think they just grabbed a lot of products they already have and put them together in a bundle and said, "Baf, this is a rainbow collection." So yeah, what do we have? You have She's a Rainbow palette. That's a lot of their single eyeshadows together in one palette. Looks really cute, looks really rainbowy, I have to say. Really nice. Then the Rainbow Road Foursome, and that is going to be $20, and I think I think that the foursome is going to be the four Super Shock Shadows, then Head in the Cloud, or is it two Super Shocks and two of these Jellymarch? I think two Super Shocks and two Jellymarch eyeshadows. Then you got the Head in the Clouds face milk set, and I think the only new one is the Acai one, it's the purple one. Then the Color Me Happy mascara set, that's just a lot of colorful mascaras, and I think they are not new. I recognize all the colors, I believe, yes. And then also the Overchromatic Cream Gel Liner set, that's also liners they already have. And the Mad About You brush set, that's just a few brushes and there's nothing rainbow about it except for the packaging they come in. So yeah, that would have been fun if they made some rainbow type of thing on the handle of the brushes. So yeah, that's the ColourPop thing for the week. I'm not going to put this on the wish list. I don't think it's interesting enough. I'm sorry. There was also BH Cosmetics, I think. Is it? It was the same type of bullshit that the other palettes were, so I'm not even going to talk about it. So if you were wondering why I'm not talking about it, it's because it's just as basic and as boring as all the Zodiac palettes up till now, so I'm not going to talk about them anymore until they are worthy to talk about. The next thing is by MAC Cosmetics. They have launched a new Studio Fix MAC foundation stick, and it's exclusively to Nordstrom. It's going to be $31 US, and yeah, it's a foundation stick. So you can get your shade. If you know your shade, you can get your shade. I think it would be a very nice product also if you like to sculpt your face with bronzing, contouring, highlighting. So I think that would be a very nice product for that as well. But as it is exclusive to Nordstrom, there's no use for me talking about this any further than that, because I can't get it. So, bye-bye. Then by Benefit, Benefit is going to launch a new concealer. It's going to be the Boeing Cakeless Concealer. I think they had these little Boeing concealer pots, and now it's going to be in a tube. There's going to be a mini and a full size. I love that Benefit has minis for almost all their products they come out with, because you can try the mini one first, and if you like it, then you can buy the full size. So I really love that they're doing that. It's going to be a multi-purpose full coverage liquid concealer that hides it all, from dark under eye circles to blemishes and discoloration. Yet it feels lightweight and doesn't cake, crack, or settle into fine lines. Well, those are some very, very big claims. So I think I'm going to try it. I'm not going to put it on the wish list, but I'll probably pick up a mini, you know, once it launched in Holland. That's going to be, I don't know when, that could be in months and months and months. So yeah, it's going to be in 12 shades. It's going to be $22 US for the full size one. And the mini is going to be in 4 shades. Why? That's annoying. But okay, that's going to be in 4 shades, and it's going to be $13 US. So yeah, so now you know. Then the next thing is by L'Oreal. L'Oreal, I think this is fun. I don't think it's coming to Holland, because not everything comes to Holland, and I don't think this is going to be something they're going to roll out here, but I think it is really fun. They are releasing limited edition Glitter Fever liners for the holiday season. And because it's limited edition, I don't even think it's coming here. I'm quite certain it won't be here, because somehow all the fun stuff never comes to Holland. But that's okay. That's okay. There are going to be 4 shades, and they are going to be exclusively in Europe. Doesn't mean it's coming to Holland. Just Europe. I'm sorry. There are 3 shades in this picture. It's like a golden color, a very icy color, and a purple, pink purple type of color. I think they're very fun. I like a glitter eyeliner once in a while. I have a very nice one from 5050 Makeup. That's an indie brand in Rotterdam. And in Rotterdam. And that's my hometown, and it's an indie brand that made really nice glitter liners. So yeah, and I've been using those, I think, for the last 2 months or something. I'm trying them out, and I really, really like them. So this is really fun. fun release for me, because I think it's fun to have just a pop of glitter in a liner form. But as I said, I don't think it's coming to Holland, so I'm not going to put it on the wish list. Then the last thing I want to talk about, I am going really fast. Yes, for once. Color Rain is going to release a new collection. It's going to be called the Power Stars Collection. It's limited edition, and it says it's going to be available on Tuesday, August 20th. That's, I think, tomorrow. Yeah, that's tomorrow when I'm filming this, at 4 p.m. It's going to be an empty magnetic palette for $45. Really? No, I don't believe that. There's going to be a power palette that it's $29. I have no idea, because I don't see if that's the eyeshadow palette or not. But they say they're going to have a 96 pen empty magnetic palette, and that's going to be $45. And I think that's the big one. If you see on the right side of the photo, on the top you see the bigger one with power on it. I think that's the one they are referring to. So yeah, you can get a very big magnetic palette in this collection. I don't like it when magnetic palettes don't have an open cover. I have all my magnetic palettes have a closed cover, and I really don't like it because I can't see what's in there. So I'm going to get some more with the like a window on top so I can see what's in there. So you've got the power palette. I think that's the eyeshadow palette. That's going to be $29. You have the highlighter and blush duo in 4 shades for $25. The liquid glitter topper for $20 in 3 different shades. The matte liquid lipstick for $17 in 2 shades. A matte bullet lipstick in 3 shades for $17. And a lip gloss for $15. I think this looks really cute and nice. And I know that a lot of people are very big fans of Color Rain. It's just, none of the colors are really calling my name. I'm not really into the berries and purples. I'm wearing purple today. That really never happens. It's just because it is in the Secret palette, and I'm using that at one of my Team Project Pan palettes at the moment. So that's why I'm wearing purple. Somehow I don't wear purple that much. But the funny thing is, of all the ColourPop like monochromatic palettes, I only have the purple one. And I've never used it until now, but still, seriously, I have to use that palette. Maybe I can put it in my Project Pan, Team Project Pan for next month, because, yeah, I don't really like purple eyeshadows. And somehow I always get drawn into them if I see them, but then I buy them, but I never wear them. So yeah, I should really stop doing it. So yeah, that's the Color Rain one. I think it looks really cute and really nice. And I think a lot of people are going to be very happy with this one. It's just not for me, so I'm not going to put this on the wish list. So guys, I'm already through this, and I think it's going to be a long one, because it's always going to be a long one, but I'm done fairly quickly this time. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. I have put some new stuff on the wish list, so if you want to know what's on the complete list, and just check out the description box down below. I've got everything down there. Thank you so much for watching. I already said that, but thank you twice. I hope you liked this video. If you did, then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And I hope I will see you in my next one. Bye.